MTC. 3. Gateway. On August 12, 1994, Major League Baseball players went on strike, bringing baseball to a halt for the rest of the season. 1994-812. The strike, which lasted 235 days, ended in April of the next year when a federal judge issued an injunction against the club owners. 2354. Just before the strike, baseball was enjoying one of the most exciting seasons in many years. The lowly Montreal Expos were leading their league by 6 games, Tony Gwynn was enjoying a .400 batting average, and a number of ball players were having banner years. Montreal Expos 6, Tony Gwynn 4. Just before the strike, the famed hitter Ken Griffey, Jr., was asked what he thought about the upcoming strike, especially since he and so many other ball players were doing so well. Ken Griffey, Jr. He replied, "We picked a bad year to have a good year. MTC. Good job. Let's start. MTC. 3. Exercise 1. If there is one recent change that stands out in student behavior, it is the decline in the willingness to read for extended periods of time. The reason is simply the competition reading faces. Until the mid-1980s, the only competition school really had was television. 1980. We still lived in a world that supported print literacy. There was still a collective memory about the experiences reading offered and a collective agreement about its value. That consensus is quickly passing away. When a teacher hands out a novel today, the first question in every student's mind is there a movie of this? If not, the next stop is the internet, where some websites will provide short chapter-by-chapter summaries, commentaries, and analysis free of charge. These sites support themselves with the extensive advertising embedded within the summary articles, a good visual distraction from the boring text summary. Today, reading literature means reading about literature. MTC. Good job. Let's start. MTC. 3. Exercise 2. It is traditionally accepted that music is an art, that painting is an art, that theater is an art no less than literature and, for more than a century now, the cinema. 1. Why not cooking? Its essential function of providing nourishment has caused us to forget that, in the hands of a great cook, a meal is capable of touching us as a love song does, of giving us joy, occasionally even of moving us to anger. To the extent that it detaches itself from tradition, which works to assign it to the status of an artisanal trade or craft, based on repetition, and insofar as its purpose is to stir the emotions, cooking, which alone among the arts stimulates all of the senses at once, cannot be excluded from their company. MTC. Good job. Let's start. MTC. 3. Exercise 3. Melatonin helps regulate the timing of when sleep occurs by systemically signaling darkness throughout the organism. But melatonin has little influence on the generation of sleep itself, a mistaken assumption that many people hold. To make clear this distinction, think of sleep as the Olympic 100-meter race. 100m. Melatonin is the voice of the timing official that says, "Runners, on your mark," and then fires the starting pistol that triggers the race. That timing official, melatonin, governs when the race, sleep, begins, but does not participate in the race. In this analogy, the sprinters themselves are other brain regions and processes that actively generate sleep. Melatonin corrals these sleep-generating regions of the brain to the starting line of bedtime. Melatonin simply provides the official instruction to commence the event of sleep, but does not participate in the sleep race itself. MTC. Good job. Let's start. MTC. 3. Exercise 4. Back in 1953, Patsy Sherman noticed a seemingly unimportant incident. 1953, Patsy Sherman. An assistant in her laboratory had spilled a few drops of an experimental chemical on her new trainers. Naturally, the assistant was upset, thinking that she wouldn't be able to get the stains off. Nothing worked, neither soap, alcohol, nor other solvents. Sherman, however, became fascinated with the chemical's incredible resilience and began forming an idea, which at the time seemed ridiculous, to develop a chemical that could repel water and oil from cloth fabrics. Sherman. By 1956, Scotch Guard Protector was launched, and the brand has been the market leader ever since. 1956, Scotch Guard Protector. A popular saying at her company is that you have to kiss an awful lot of frogs before you find your prince. Failing is par for the course when it comes to innovation and product development. MTC. Good job.